Alrighty, time for round two on the play. What do we got? Alright. This hand's great. It's basically a three-card hand, because Simeon Spirit Guide, Splinter Twin, and Bloodstained Mire are the only cards I know I have. The rest of the cards are going to cycle, so I'm just going to go Bloodstained Mire Go, I believe. And I end of turn. I guess I do want to draw land, so I can just cycle both Street Wraiths before cracking the Mire, at which point I will crack the Mire and cycle Monster Scarabid or Deadshot Minotaur. Alright, let's go Mire Go. So what do we want to see? I guess maybe Jund would be one of the better matchups, though I did have a pretty close match against Jund last time. Mono white, I assume. Instant or sorcery. Whew, close one. Alright, yeah, that works. Street Wraith. Street Wraith. Alright, so now that I hit the swamp, I'm probably just getting red-green. I get Stomping Ground here. And I'm cycling Deadshot Minotaur. Alright. So, I've got a lot of the cards I need here. That was not one of them. Let's play Swamp, say go. If I can hit a cycling card, I imagine I just win the game. If I can hit a Pestermite or Deceiver Exarch, I probably also just win the game. So, doubled outs to win. Alright. Honor of the Pure, huh? Living End, huh? Well, that's Living End's kind of like the anti-out. If I hit the third Living End, that's really bad for me. I mean, hitting the first two is already very bad, but I still have a couple more turns here. So, you know, a lot of cards I can hit. Alright, that is one of them. I'm just going to pass. I don't really want to play Deceiver Exarch on upkeep, because first of all, my opponent's not going to kill me with Dryad Militant there. And I would like my opponent to tap out for like a Spectral Procession or something along those lines. I don't want them to have Path to Exile up, which is easily a card they can have. So I'm hoping they'll tap out for a 3-drop here. Squadron Hawk. Alright, well. Yeah, I guess it's a little unfortunate in the sense that if I do Exarch my opponent's plans and they have Path, then may not be able to win very easily, but alright, looks like they don't, and looks like Splinter Twin's gonna win again. I guess I don't need to show my opponent Simeon Spirit Guide here. Alright, let's get a mountain. Splinter Twin the Exarch, and this is exactly how we drew it up. I hate it when my opponents make me go through it. Alright, there we go. Well, that was the plan, so. Now, it's kind of interesting because I don't really know what my opponent's going to be bringing in terms of their sideboarding options. I mean, I guess Shriekmaw's okay. It seems like Shriekmaw can't be too bad. I do think I like all the combo pieces. I took out like one Spirit Guide. I guess I could take out a Living End, but I don't even know. I don't even like doing that. I know some people side them out sometimes, but I just bring in the one Shriekmaw. There aren't even that many cards I care about, honestly. Once I see game two, whether I see what kind of hate cards my opponent has, I might have to change that. But for now, my main deck's got to be so insane. Both combos are very good against Mono White. All right. yeah, this is a pretty classic opening hand of Swamp, Mountain, Double Twins, Double Street Wraith, Deceiver Exarch. I think it's a fine hand, though. If I can find a blue source and a red source, I can cast Twin Exarch. And even if I can't, I've got some Street Wraiths. All right, I'm actually going to cycle these now because I want to see. Oh, there we go. That was the answer to my question. I wanted to find out which cycling card I had so I knew which land to play. And the cool thing is my opponent actually has to tap out to try and kill me. They can't just sit there and do nothing. Ooh, Oriok Champion, boo. That actually makes it so the Deceiver Exarch doesn't actually win the game. Pestermite still does. Demonic Dread still very much does. I can't Demonic Dread that. Let's see. Alright, I guess I'll get Stomping Ground and tapped. Though, alright, so I've got some options here. First of all, if my opponent plays another creature that does not have protection from black and red. I can cast Demonic Dread and get back four creatures, which is pretty good start. The other thing is, all right, rest in peace. That's unfortunate. The other thing is, I can play Deceiver Exarch to block Oriok Champion. Of course, now there's a Soul's Attendant in play. My opponent kind of has the lock. All right, well, I guess that'll make me change what I want to do here. Let's just pass the turn. Oh, actually, no, I shouldn't have passed the turn. Yeah, that was bad. I mean, I guess because of the Windswept Teeth or Windbrisk Kites, I kind of like just waiting an extra turn, but I do plan on using Demonic Dread to wipe my opponent's board. Even without Rest in Peace, Demonic Dread is still a wrath, because it just goes and gets a Living End and kills everything. Alright. I'll take two. I'm not going to play the Exarch here. I want my opponent to play another creature, and because they have Windbrisk Kites, they've got to have incentive to do that, right? Alright, Martyr of Sands is fine. I guess I'll get a blue source with this. Ooh, could my opponent play one more creature? I would like that. I mean, three is the perfect number to use Windbrisk, so wouldn't be surprised if they held off. Ooh, okay. So sacking Martyr. That's interesting. Gaining six, revealing Sarah Ascendant Soul's Warden. All right. Soul Warden. I like my spot, because now if my opponent plays Soul Warden here, which I guess they're not going to if they didn't do that, they would have played that first. Well, my Demonic Dread's about to be awesome. All right, so let's go ahead and get Steam Vents. I guess I have the Watery Grew, so I didn't need that much. Yeah, why wouldn't another Living End show up? All right, let's cast Living End and play Watery Grave. And pass. So my opponent just has Soul Warden in play. I'm going to play a land and pass. And hopefully in two draw steps, they don't draw a way to not die. I mean, or to not kill my Exarch. Or I could just draw a Pestermite. I could actually just cast Deadshot Minotaur, and I don't think that's an unreasonable play. What I am going to do is just give my opponent one turn to attack Soul Warden into Deceiver Exarch, which I don't think is... Alright, well, that's annoying. Well, I'm probably still just playing Deceiver Exarch to kill the Soul Warden here. Seems definitely worth it, even if it is annoying. Opponent had to draw two, or actually just one. Soul Warden was already there. Had to draw one Soul Warden type effect. Does my opponent have the Path to Exile? They do. Wow. Alright. I guess there aren't any basics left, do I? Well, they do Path and Soul Warden, so I guess I'm not killing them with my twin combo quite yet. I could just draw Pestermite, though. That would be nice. Alright, Deceiver Exarch's no Pestermite, but there's a good chance my opponent still attacks with both, in which case I get to kill Oriok Champion, which is slightly better. Okay. Sarah Ascendant. That's going to be mildly annoying, but I guess I can use Splinter Twin on Exarch to tap down Sarah Ascendant. Come on, attack me. Yeah, they don't want to. Alright, well, I'm still playing Deceiver Exarch, even though I can't go off infinitely here. But I still would like a way to not die to Sarah Ascendant. So, let's untap. Splinter Twin, the Exarch. Opponent's on no cards, so this isn't terrible for me. Land and pass. I could cycle Deadshot Minotaur, but might actually be good to cast at some point here. So now, what am I hoping to draw? Shriek Maw would be amazing. I guess it doesn't kill Oriok Champion. Shriek Maw plus Pestermite? Yeah, this isn't great. I am definitely going to sideboard differently. I should have, I guess, sideboarded more against the Oriok Champion type cards, but the fact that I have Living End to wrath them is pretty relevant. I don't have any Living Ends left here. So now, what is my plan? I guess I could suspend Living End, and then in a bunch of turns, if I drew another Pestermite, plan on using that to go off. My opponent could draw a land at some point. That would be good for me. All right. Let's cast Deadshot Minotaur, I guess. I mean, it doesn't kill the Saracen, though I can eventually Splinter Twin the Deadshot Minotaur and then use it to attack, to play it, to tap it, put another one into play, then cast another one and kill it. All right, that's a start, I guess. Oh, let's pass the turn. Or actually, I can just Splinter Twin the Deadshot Minotaur and then tap Deceiver Exarch to make another copy, to untap the Deadshot Minotaur, to tap the Deadshot Minotaur again. Uh-oh. Spectral Procession. All right, Deadshot Minotaur is going to do some work. I actually think I might be fine here. I mean, obviously my opponent can just draw Path to Exile and I just lose the game on the spot. But if that doesn't happen, I kind of like my spot. Opponents have millions, but that's okay. This is an absurd game, by the way. I don't think I'm going to have very many games that I win with this manner. Since my plan now is to Splinter Twin Deadshot Minotaur, and then at the when my opponent attacks, make two Deadshot Minotaurs and use them to kill, to kill the Sarah Ascendant, taking three from the Spirit Tokens. And then after that, I can start using Deadshot Minotaur to pick off the Spirit Tokens. I'm waiting now because if my opponent played a Honor of the Pure or something, I would want to do that. Oh, I guess this actually lets my opponent... Ooh, this is actually kind of interesting. Do I want my opponent to... No, they can win Brisk Heights no matter what. I can't stop that. So... I mean, I could have killed two Spirit Tokens. And if I did, then... Yeah. Then my opponent could have attacked, but then I get attacked for so much damage. All right. So now I'm getting hit for three. Hopefully the card under Windbrisk Heights is not... Oh, wow, my opponent didn't attack? All right, that's pretty awesome for me. Time for me to start attacking. Actually, let's just go with Deadshot Minotaur. Let's start with this, because it doesn't have to attack, at least. And I know the Warlock Champion stops my attackers, but I do get to start tapping it with Deceiver Exarch. Uh-oh. Honor of the Pure? Well, that doesn't stop me quite here. And this is giving my opponent so much life. But once we're done here, then I don't have to make quite as many copies. They start actually getting positive life. I actually don't know if I can kill my opponent this way. We'll find out, though. And eventually I just keep drawing creatures, so I can just keep casting bigger creatures. So that's the goal, at least. All right. Do I want to Splinter Twin something else? No, I think I'll just cast Monstrous Carabid. And then... Now it's time to start attacking. I'm going to wait a turn. And the end of my opponent's turn, I'm going to tap the Oriok Champion with my Deceiver copy. And then make a Deadshot Minotaur, because it still deals one damage. And then I get to attack with the Exarch, the Minotaur, and the Carabid. This is pretty normal game of Magic, honestly. Oh, actually, wait. Oh, no, I can't make infinite dead shots. I can only make one. For a second, I thought I could make lots of Deadshot Minotaurs, but that's not how that works. And even if I have Splinter Twin on, like, two things, that doesn't give me more Deadshot Minotaurs, sadly. Yeah, I guess I could... Time my opponent out too? Yeah. I don't think I want to Splinter Twin anything. So my opponent's gaining 4 life a turn, but is now taking 11. Oh, I guess he gets Soul Warden gets to block because of Honor of the Pure. Though actually, killing the Soul Warden is kind of big, so I'm going to cast a Violent Outburst. Again, using my cards the way they normally are intended to be used. Killing the Soul Warden and dealing massive amounts of damage, but now my Splinter Twins hurt a lot less, and if I draw Pestermite, now I can actually win. And now I get to do an extra 2 damage a turn because I'm making 2 copies and they're getting 2 less life. Sarah Ascendant. Well, we know what's going to happen with that. It's going to get deadshotted right on out. This is just an absurd game. And bam, there goes this. Oh, wait, it does. Oh, yeah, of course that doesn't work because I have. There's the Honored up here. Well, whatever. Just drew Shriek Maw. I guess that's even better. Because now I can Splinter Twin a Shriek Maw if I want to. So I actually could have, this turn, killed the Saracen by putting a third Splinter Twin on my creature here, but that it was not, in fact, necessary. Alright. So yeah, my plan was, I should have just tapped the Auriak Champion end of turn, done the rest the same, and then untapped, planned to Splinter Twin this other Deadshot Minotaur, but instead just drew Shriek Maw. Alright, another Honor of the Pure is fine. You know, we're kind of getting close to hitting my opponent here. I mean, I'm going to do some decent damage. I could just drop Pestermite, but this is way better. Ooh, Jungle Weaver, I'll be casting that one soon. Like, I'm doing, what is that, 10, 14 damage a turn? It doesn't take that long. Yeah, I'm going to wait on this Jungle Weaver. You never know. I'm only 1 mana short. I guess I have to get Overgrown Tomb with this Bloodstained Mire so I can cast it. But once I've cast Jungle Weaver, the game is kind of over. Alright, Honor of the Pures are fine. I guess if my opponent attacks me now... Oh, that's the same. I can just put a token to play to chump. It's the same as... I guess that's slightly better for my opponent if they attack. But... And you know what? Actually, I'm going to sack this. Get Overgrown Tomb tapped. If I draw an untapped land, I guess I don't even have any untapped lands to draw. I didn't want to take much damage, so, but I guess it doesn't matter, because this, probably not taking 3 to cast Jungle Weaver, though actually, that might be fine. It's not like my opponent's going to get to hit me anymore. Alright, I guess I'll get my Blood Crypt, or I guess I can get Breeding Pool. And cast a Jungle Weaver. Oh, yep. Yeah. I mean, certainly couldn't cycle Jungle Weaver. You know, the goal's within sight. I'm going to kill my opponent very soon here with the classic Splinter Twin Deadshot Minotaur lock. I mean, I don't know, I really know how you get out of that. Besides, you know, Path to Exile, which would be fairly annoying. Ooh, Simian Spirit Guide. I'll probably cast in that one, too. Alright, so this puts my opponent down to 15. They're actually dead next turn. Well, that's sweet. So even if they drew a path this turn, I could have, like, untapped Jungle Weaver with my Exarch. Can still tap my opponent's Auriak Champion. Soul's Attendant. Yeah, I guess there's no reason to do it in response here. If my opponent wants to attack, I'll tap Soul's Attendant and put a token into play. Alright. And then now... So opponent's at 19... How much damage am I dealing? 4, 7, 10, 15, 19. So if I tap Soul's Attendant and attack, that is presumably lethal. Is that better? What do I lose to there? If my opponent has a path, I think. Here, let's just go. This is probably safer. Splinter Twin on Shriek Maw. Shriek Maw the Soul's Attendant. This is, plus, I want to just cast as many Splinter Twins as I can this game. It's too sweet. And now I can attack my opponent for 6, 12, 19. I guess what I need to do here is, I mean, this is the only play, is Splinter Twin my Jungle Weaver. And then I can make a token with Jungle Weaver, and then I can use Deceiver Exarch to make another Jungle Weaver. So we have the full 4 Splinter Twins active. And then now I can attack with everything, and that's 11, plus 7 is 18, plus 10 is like 28. All right. I didn't actually play around path. I just got to a point where I realized I wanted to make the full four Splinter Twins and and attack with everything. I mean, this is just a ridiculous screen.